Hi guys, and thanks for watching again. In one of my previous videos, I promised you to show you the beer brewing I do. And that's exactly what I'm going to do today. I'm going to use these ingredients, I'm going to brew a beer, I'm going to show you how I made a recipe for my beer, and I'm going to show you, of course, the Bulldog brewer I use. But first, let's start with the ingredients. That's the basis of the beer. So these are hops. And I wrote down there 40 grams of Cascade hops. I'm not going to use that amount, but this is what hops look like. These are dried, the hop flowers. This is the yeast I will be using. And this is the malt I will be using. Now, we're not going to add these all in one bucket and then it is beer. First, we need to mill the malt. So we crack the shells of the malts over there, and so water can float through to it. We're going to boil that, we're going to add the hops and cool it all down again as fast as we can, and then add the yeast, and the yeast will do the rest. It will transfer all the sugars into alcohol in the next coming days, and of course I will film the process of the yeast. There's not much to see, but I add a water lock on top of the fermenting box, the fermenting barrel, so you see it bubbling because that's what it is doing. But first, let's switch to my computer screen. I made a recipe, and that's also quite interesting to see. So there we go. Now, this is a program called Brouwhulp, and it is Dutch, and I'm not sure if it is available in other languages, but at least I have the Dutch version. It is made by a Dutch guy, so I'm not sure. I will translate some of it. These are my recipes, and I've called this one the Citrus IPA for now. I'm not sure if it is, it will be a good beer, so I have no name for it yet. And it is a American IPA, because I'm going to use a lot of hops and I'm going to add some citrus over there. So yeah, these are the ingredients. The colorful part are the ingredients. I start with 7 kilograms of pale ale malt. And I'm going to mill that, of course, and add it all to the water. And I'm going to make that 63 degrees Celsius for about 30 minutes. Then I'm going to increase the temperature to 73 degrees for another 30 minutes. And then I'm going to finish to 78 degrees, only 3 minutes. And when that is done, I pull it all out of the wort, which is cold at that moment. And then I'm going to add probably 7 liters of 78 degrees Celsius water over it, so that I have my 24 liters of beer again over here. Now, at 60 minutes of boiling, so the entire boil time, I'm going to boil it for 60 minutes, I'm going to add Saaz hops, 50 grams of it, which is mainly responsible for the bitterness of the beer. And after that, for 45 minutes and 30 minutes, I'm going to add some flavor and hops. American hops, Cascade, Citra and Amarillo, and those are responsible for the fruitiness and also the bitterness of the beer. And when it is all done and it is sitting in the fermenting barrel, I'm gonna add some citrus, some orange peel, the bitter ones and the sweet ones, and add the Fermentis S04 yeast. Now, it sounds easy, but it is a lot of work. I'm estimating that I will be brewing for the next 4 hours. And this one is also interesting. This program estimated my sugar contents of 1 and then 1064, the sugar contents. And that's important because the sugars will be converted to alcohol by the yeast. And the program estimates that this yeast will make the sugar contents go down to this, which is somewhat lower, and the rest of the sugars are transferred to alcohol. So this program also estimates that the final beer will have a 6.2% alcohol. So that's nice for an IPA. These are also interesting. These are the sugar contents, and for an American IPA, we want my line to be in the green area over here, which is it is currently somewhat in the center, and this is the bitterness. And we want also, for an American IPA, we want it to be in the green area. Now, I like my beers bitter, so I add some extra hops to get it somewhat bitter. Let's see what happens if I change the cascade from 20 grams to 30 grams. And now you see over here that the line went into the red, so it's way too bitter for an American IPA. At least that's what this program thinks. I still like it. It's also for the bitterness index, and this is the color. The color will be 15 EBC, a light IPA, and the alcohol is also in the cream. So that's all good. So let's start. I'm going to add water first, get it to the 63 degrees temperature, mill the malts, and then add them all to the Bulldog Brewer. So there we go. Now this is the Bulldog Brewer I just mentioned. Look at that, Bulldog Brewer. And this is what it's doing while it is just powered on. And take a look inside. There it is. I just thoroughly cleaned it with this stuff. It's Puro Oxy. It's just oxygen in little bubbles, I guess. And this is what it is doing while it is powered on. Let me make the camera steady in its position like that. And I'm gonna turn it on. There we are. The 24 liters of water are currently somewhat 18 or 20 degrees. Don't know why it's not saying 19, because it is it's accurate to a degree. And I'm going to need the water to be 63 degrees. I'm gonna push the temp button and increase it. To 63, and then let's wait what it was doing, and then power it on. And then, as you can see, it is currently set at 700 watts, and I'm gonna increase the power to not 1800 but 2500 watts. Now that's gonna take a nice amount of power, and it is going to take a couple of minutes to increase the temperature to 63 degrees. And when it is done, I'm going to add the milled malt and I'm going to mill that right now. So there we go. Now this is the malt mill, and as you can see inside, when I rotate the lever, two barrels rotate in opposite directions and it will mill the malt. So I need to weigh, this is approximately 5 kilograms. I need to weigh the 7 kilos I need. So there we go. So that's the first 2 kilograms. More left in there. 2 kilograms in there. And I'm gonna continue until I have 7 kilograms. Now it's time for me to start milling. And the noise you hear in the background is, of course, the giant water cooker, the Bulldog Brewer. And I've placed an empty bucket below the mill, so that we catch all the milled malt. And yes, it makes this nice squeaky noise. But let me skip to the end. Now this is what the crushed malt looks like. As you can see, the white stuff from the inside is now available for the water, so that's fine. So this is only 4 kilos. I need to do 3 more, and my arm is already getting tired. But this thing, it allows me to add a drill, but I have not done yet so far, so maybe next time. Now it's ready. It's 63 degrees Celsius and it stopped making noise, and I've added a little pump to that, so we can pump the liquid from below to the top, so that I don't have to stir it all the time. Now let's pour in all the malts. Now first, let's take the lid off. That's 3 kilos. There we are. It's almost full. That's great. That's making optimal use of my brewer. Gonna add this lid. Let's find the metal rod inside first. There we are. Okay, let's add the pump. And turn it on. But first, of course, I can turn it on, but I have to open the valve. There we are. Now, it should be pumping. Let's double check. If I can do that with one hand, let's zoom out a little bit. Oh. Great, great. So, that needs to be sitting there for 30 minutes. Now let's take another sneak peek. Oh, that looks good. Oh, if you could only smell this, it is awesome. Now the first 30 minutes have passed, so I need to increase the temperature to, let's say, 73 degrees. First I need to press this button, of course. And I said, let's say, but I made a recipe, of course. And I have to stick to it, so this needs to be 73 degrees Celsius for another 30 minutes. So there we go, it is set at 2500 watts, still. And now it starts making noise again. This giant water cooker. So there we go, for another 30 minutes. Now I've added 7 kilograms of malt to the water, which means I also need about 7 liters. The Lidl market is over there, I don't know if you can see it, but I'm gonna heat up 7 liters of water to 78 degrees, the last step of the heating process. And I'm gonna need this water to flush out the last sugars and the last coolies out of the malt. And yeah, just on the, oh, I can put it on higher power. So, and I'm gonna use just a normal temperature measurement unit to see how hot it is. So, we're gonna need this water in a couple of minutes, I guess. Now, for the final step, we need to increase the temperature to 78 degrees Celsius for about 3 minutes. So, let's do that. 78 degrees Celsius. My water, my 7 liters of water, is already at 78 degrees Celsius. So, as soon as this had its 3 minutes, I'm gonna add that water, flush all the malt, and then let's remove the malt and boil what's left of it, about 25 liters, I guess. So, there we go. Now, the 3 minutes are passed and I'm gonna shut down the pump. And the liquid will probably fall to about here. And put this in here, or else it will leak at the ground and my wife is probably not too happy about that. Right. Remove the lid. Sink. Remove this one as well. That is quite hot. 78 degrees to be exact. It's still probably. Look at that. Alright. Now where are the holes? I think I have never seen it this full before. Oh. Let me lift it a little bit to search for the holes. Ah, there it is. So where's the other part? Ah, here it is. Now I can lift this. And put it in its first stage. It's going to make all nasty sounds, but all the water is now flowing back into the main body. And I'll wait a little bit. Looks good. I'm going to lift it a second time. And now it's time to add the full pan water. To flush the last goodies out of the barley. And while that is dripping, I need to set it to a boiling temperature. 102 is enough. So there we go. Now I'm going to need to add 50 grams of Saaz hops, but before I continue, I wanted to show you this. I used this thermometer to measure. I wanted to measure the temperature of the water which was in there, but as you can see, the red line, it split itself. There is something over here with on my ring finger. I don't know if that's called a ring finger in English, but in Dutch it is. Do any one of you know how to fix this giant air bubble in between? Because I loved using this, it was pretty accurate, and now it is useless. So I had to refer to that one. It's too bad. So I'm gonna add 50 grams of hops. Let me position the camera first. There we go. Probably not all 50 grams gonna fit in this bowl. Grab another one. Let's try and get 25 grams in here. Fine, 25 grams. Almost there. How about this? Oh, that was too much. Yeah, I'm kind of picky when it comes to the weight of the hops. I want it to be exact. This should do it. Yes. Now we have 50 grams of Saaz hops, which we're gonna add in about a couple of minutes. The water is currently at 80. The wort. It's currently at 85 degrees, so a couple of more minutes waiting, I'll add this. Now it's almost boiling, which means that it is time to add the inner barrel again. Inner body, whatever you call it. And I've cleaned it, of course, all the barley was removed. I've cleaned the tank and now it is boiling. Now it is not anymore, yeah, but it is boiling. Gently, but it is. Let's look at the temperature, 100 degrees, so it needs to rise two more. But it starts boiling, so that's a good sign. So I wait till it reaches the 102 and then I'm gonna add the hops. Now it is boiling, it's time to add the hops. There we go, 25 grams. And another 25 grams of Saaz hops. Let's get my spoon. And mix it a little bit. Now this inner body takes also care for removing the hops later on. It makes it a whole lot easier for me to filter out all the hops. Of course I can use those bags, but this thing is just made for this, so this is nice. Now I'm gonna leave it boiling, and it is very important for me not to close the lid right now, because if I close it, you will taste the DMS in the beer, and the beer just tastes like just cooked vegetables, and we don't want that. But the hops are now all on top, and they will soak up some water and then flow through the entire body and the entire wort. So now it's time to leave it boiling for another 15 minutes, because I need to add more hops later on. So wait a couple of minutes. Now it's time to add the 20 grams of Cascade hop, like we say in Dutch, and mix it again, because the first 15 minutes have passed, and now let's wait another 15 minutes till we can add the Citra hops. Now, and with beer brewing goes beer drinking, of course. This is the Devil's Piss I have brewed before, so let's taste it. Oh, that's lovely. Yeah, super. Another 15 minutes have gone by, so it's time to add the Citra hops. There we go. That's a lot of hops. This beer will be bitter, but that was to be expected, and I like bitter beers, so there we go. Oops, I almost forgot the Amarillo hops. They also need to be added at the 30 minute stage, so that's what I'm going to do. And as you can see, these are hop pellets and not the hop flowers I wanted to use, because the last time I was at the shop, they didn't have the flowers, they only had this, so I had to pick this. So I'm going to add this one. So just add it like that, 20 grams Amarillo hops. It makes just a nice little hops soup. Nice. So after 30 minutes, the boiling is done, and we can cool the beer. So let's see. It's 102 degrees. So that's awesome. 30 more minutes. Now the boiling is done. The hops are removed. Now I only need to cool it down. So I'm gonna flow fresh, cool water through the spiral, gonna sink it down, make sure that the hoses are not blocked and all the water can flow freely. Right, turn a little bit faster. Right, now we saw earlier that the water coming out of my tap was about 18, 19 degrees, 20 degrees somewhat, and that's as far as we can cool, of course. So let's see how fast it cools actually. There we are, a moment ago it was at 101 degrees, and now it's already cooled down to 87 degrees, and it will cool down further quite fast until we get to about, let's say, 30 degrees, 40 degrees, and it will not cool as fast as anymore, of course, because the water flowing through it is not that cold. It's not ice water. I wish I had ice water flowing from my tap, but I don't. So yeah, this is what we will have to do. There we see it's already 80 degrees, 79 probably within a second. There we go. So yeah, and we need to do this as fast as possible, of course, because now the wort, the beer actually, is very sensitive to infections, because at 100 degrees there is no problem, because that bacteria don't like the temperature. But this temperature, however, is bacteria like it very much, so we need to be extra careful right now not to get it infected. That's exactly why I have cleaned everything through thoroughly. So yeah, there we go, 73 degrees, and As soon as it's about 25 degrees, I'm gonna put it in a my fermenting box, fermenting barrel, and then add the yeast, and then we're done. Oh no, we're not done. I have to add the citrus peel I made in my recipe. I'm gonna add orange peel, bitter and sweet, and I'm also gonna add some lemon peel. So yeah, within a few moments this is cooled down, and then we're gonna start fermenting. Now, while the beer is cooling, I'm gonna take a sample to measure the sugar contents, and I'm gonna use this device, and I've cleaned it from the inside and outside because we don't want any infections right now. That's why I am talking not towards this kettle but in another direction, so that the contents of my mouth do not enter this. Take a few drips, that's enough. Now I need to add these drips to my refractometer. Oh, it is, I'm making a mess here. Let's close it fast. There's some air bubbles. I will fix it without having to hold the camera, one moment. Now the air bubbles are gone, and let's see what we see. Let's see if I can get... There we are. There you can see the blue line, at least the difference between the blue and the white. And it's about 1,049. So that's our sugar content, 1.049. And I'm gonna see if that's what we calculated with the program. Now, the program estimated that the start sugar contents would be 1.064, and we just saw that it reached a 1.049. So we didn't reach the 1.064. We can do two things. We can leave it like that and just say fuck it, we don't give a fuck. Or we can add sugar to reach this. And I'm all for the first option. Just fuck it. I mean, yeah, the alcohol contents are going to be a little bit lower, but yeah, I don't really care. So, yeah, we just have to do with the 1.049. Let's see if I can put it down. Measurements on the day of brewing, that's what this tab says, and I can probably... we didn't measure the pH. Probably it's handier to enter the values. It says start, blend, end. I do not know the end yet, so we'll have to see about that later on. Volume. I just probably saw a 25 liter volume. Why can't I edit this? I don't know. Anyway, I have a calculator online to calculate the alcohol. So for now, I think it's okay, the 1.049. So next step, when it is cooled, I'm going to add it to the fermenting barrel and then add the yeast. So within a few moments, we're going to do that. Now, as you can see, it is almost 25 degrees. That is the temperature where I want to start the fermenting with the yeast. And let's look at the beer first. It's still cooling, and it has this nice brownish color, and it is it's not clear, but it will clear up. But let's see, 27 degrees, two more degrees to go, and then I'm going to add it to my fermenting bucket or barrel, as you want to call it. So few more minutes, I guess. Now it's time to add the beer from the Bulldog Brewer into this fermenting box, fermenting bucket, barrel, whatever. So I'm gonna let it clatter it in so that it gets oxygen. That's rather important. The yeast also likes oxygen. And this will, of course, create some foam. So this will take a while, 24 liters. Now
Now, of course, before we start the fermenting, I also want to taste it. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to tap a little bit of this freshly brewed beer and taste it. But I need two hands, so I cannot hold the camera. So I extracted some beer and let's taste it. Ooh, that is very sweet, of course, because the sugars have not yet been converted to alcohol, and also very bitter. Oh, I would say rather unpleasant right now, but somehow not bad. It is, yeah, I still like it. Yeah, this is a complicated flavor. Another sip. Yeah, this is an IPA, definitely. Right, yeah, let's wait until the fermenting bucket is full so we can add the yeast and all the citrus peels. Now, I don't know why the camera was not recording, but I've added 150 grams of orange peel bitter. I've added 50 grams of orange lemon peel bitter. So there's 100 gram in this bowl. Now I'm going to add another 50 grams of this. This is the orange peel sweet. 50 grams I need. Oops, just a little bit too much. Now my bag just closed. Now the reason I wanted to be this precise is because when I want to recreate this beer, I want it to be exact. If this beer somehow is miraculously juicy or good, I want the ability to recreate it. So now I have 150 grams of all citrus peels, which I'm going to add. So there we go. As you can see, there's still some foam left of all the clattering. There's the orange peel sweet, orange peel bitter, and lime peel. Let's mix it. Oh, the smell is nice, actually. Right. Now that is done. Now I need to add the yeast. Now I'm going to add this yeast. And these are just, let's see if I can get the light correct, somewhat. And some focus. There we are. All tiny little, yeah, circles, spheres of living yeast. So we're gonna add that. So there we go. Bag is empty. Stir again. Now this stirring also creates oxygen into the beer. That's what you want. And I'm also spoiling some of the beer onto the crown. That's not only a waste of the perfectly good beer, but also, which means I have to mop the floor after I'm done, which I also had to do because all this beer is very sweet and just very sticky to the floor. So, well, I think it is fairly mixed right now, so it's time to close it. Now the lid is closed and it is quite dark in here because now we're in my man cave. And I've added a water lock to the top. And since it is so dark in here, you can barely see it. But this water lock will prevent oxygen from going in, so the beer will not corrode. And it allows the carbon dioxide, if I'm not mistaken, to go out, because it will create, the yeast will create the carbon dioxide, and it needs to go out. If it is entirely closed, the barrel will explode. Now, I'm going to place it in this box, and inside this box, it is too dark. I need some light. One moment. There we are, some light. Inside this box are three Peltier elements, two for cooling and one for heating. And here is the beer bottle again, the beer bucket. And on the outside, I need some light there too. One moment. And on the outside, I added a Raspberry Pi, six relays, and of course it all is powered by one ATX power supply. And the software on the Raspberry Pi measures the temperature by using four of these. This just looks like a transistor, but it is a temperature sensor. This one is on the outside. I have two more going up outside. And let me just see with this light. You can see there's one over there. There's one over there inside the box. And there's a total of four of these temperature sensors inside. So the Raspberry Pi is monitoring the temperature outside and inside, so it can keep the temperature inside the box at an exact temperature. So that's what I'm going to do, because I want this beer to be fermenting at exactly 19 degrees. So I'm going to set the temperature, and when it starts bubbling, I'll probably make another video. So for now, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this beer making video.